Welcome to another GrandMA3 tutorial. This time we're going to talk about selection grid and M-matrix. Selection grid and M-matrix are two different things, but they are kind of connected. I mean, you can use both without using the other, but working with them together is extremely powerful, and I'm going to show you why it's really powerful in this tutorial. So if you are interested in selection grid and M-matrix, this is definitely the tutorial for you. So let's start in our view here with our layout default view. We don't need that. We can close it down and we can open our selection grid. We can scale it a little bit down like this. We can open our layout view over here. If I can find it, there we go. We can put it all the way up here and we can open our M-matrix down here. So this is the view we need. Let's have a look at our screen right now. I have my selection grid up here. You can open that window. I have my layout view over here so we can see what's going on. And I have my M-matrix down here. So let's start with our selection grid. Our selection grid is a representation of our fixtures in X, Y, and Z space. You can turn on X, Y, and Z down here in your M-matrix window. And you can scroll down and say, okay, this is our y-axis, this is our z-axis, and this is our x-axis. In this tutorial, we are only going to work on the x-axis. So if we close these ones down, then they disappear, then they're not going to clutter our view here. Up here, we have our selection grid, and if I choose a range of fixtures, it's going to open up in our selection grid. And now we can use our M-matrix to manipulate whatever's going on up here. So if I press this one, the X, it's basically the same thing as pressing next on your console or on your keyboard. Right now I'm just using my keyboard and I can go back and forth. So that's fine. If I want to have some blocks, I can say I have two blocks. And if you look at our layout view over here now, and you have to open the layout view to see exactly what's going on. Now it's choosing blocks of two every time I am moving one step forward. And again, if I want blocks of three, blocks of four, and basically this means that if I apply an effect or a color or whatever, it's gonna do it on all those four simultaneously. So if I go back again, block, and then go down to group, then I can group them in groups of two, groups of three, four, five, six, and say, for instance, we let's just clear this and say we want to select this one up here and we want to select all our washes. Then you can see we have all 24 fixtures selected like this. But if I use my group and press next, I can simply say I want them in groups of 12. Then it's going to take the first ones of each fixture type. So it's basically going to say, okay, I have 24 fixtures, but I choose fixture number one, and then I skip the next 11, and then I take the next one, skip the next 11, and so on and so forth. So basically, that's how grouping works. Let's just reset grouping again down to nothing, and then say wings. What are wings? Wings are basically you choose the first and the last one in a selection with a group of or with wings of two. So if you see here, it chose the first one and it chose the last one, which is fine if you have a group. If we clear this and say, I just want to choose these ones up here, and then I apply wings of two. And when I press next, it's going to take number one and number 12, and then all the way towards the center. And this is the way it works. But there's another way we can do this with using our grid layout. Let's just go in and off everything here. Let's take our master queue list down. There we go. If I choose all my profile spots like this, and then I choose all my auras, then they come in after each other. I can take another tool, which is new, I believe, to the GrandMA3, and set a width of one, which selects all of them at once. The next one divides it into two groups. into 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so on and so forth. And if I go all the way up to 12 like this, then it's going to select the first one. Let's just reset that one and go all the way up to this one. Then it's going to select the first one in the row, the next one in the row, and so on. So this is how grid is really powerful. And again, if we take all our profile spots, we select them, where the blue square is, this is where it's going to place the next selected fixture. So basically, if I put the next selected fixture down here, and I choose this range, it's going to come right underneath it. And again, I can do it with, oh, and I need to put it down here. I can do it with all our dimmers. And then I can say, okay, I have all my atomics here. I only have 6 atomics, but I have 12 of every other fixture. So I can just place my blue cursor and then skip one, select a fixture, skip one, select a fixture, skip two and select it. And then I suddenly have a different layout. And if I have this layout and apply an effect and I apply an effect to it, then it's going to see all this as basically one fixture or one, one selection. So if I go into my dimmers, for instance, and say at 0, then I choose the next step. Oh, here we go. 0. Then I choose my next step. I set that to 100. And then it's going to start oscillating between 0 and 100. If I go in and apply a phase to that, 0 through 360, for instance, you see it's going to follow, it's going to follow the selection. So basically, it's going to say all in the first selection here is treated as one fixture. It's going to apply the same dimmer effect to it and the next one and so forth. And if we go into the phaser and set another way of looking at it, then it's going to be like this. This would be a little bit difficult to do. It's not impossible, but it's going to be a little bit difficult to do on GrandMA3 because you need to calculate some, you have to have some dummy fixtures in between here or something like that to make sure that it selects it in the right order. But here, it's very, very easy to set up your selection or your grid or your fixtures in the selection grid. And then you can actually store it. So if I say store right now, oh, that was the select button. That was the add button. Here we go. If I say store to this right here and I clear, when I select the group next time, it already has this fixture selection. So now you can change the fixture selection around as much as you want. You also have the shuffle over here. So once again, if we select all our fixtures like this, maybe we put it into the group selection we already had. Let's once again start an effect. We say 0 on step 1. We say 100 on step 2. It starts to oscillate. Then if I shuffle down here like this and apply a phase to it, 0 through 360 again, sorry, and then I shuffle it, then you can see it's going to shuffle, and every time I push the shuffle here, it's going to choose a different randomization of the fixtures. And I think you can actually see it if you zoom in here, 704, 304, 110, and so on. So basically, it just moves everything around so you can do really complex things. And that's the shuffle up here. So there's a lot of interesting things in the new selection grid combined with the MAtricks. So play with it and learn how it works. I mean, it's quite simple to work with as soon as you get your head around it for the first time. You have to see a few tutorials and then it actually starts to make sense. But it's a pretty cool tool. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and maybe even subscribe to the channel, and that way you get a notification next time we upload a video. So I hope you get something out of this, and if you have any questions, please leave a comment down below and I will try to answer them as good as I can. See you next time. Bye-bye.